music's greatest songs. Greatest songs worth covering. Original classic hitmakers.
So we're going back to 1996. We're going back to a boy band called Damage. And why are we doing this? Because actually, for a lot of countries across the world, you'd be like, who? Who's Damage? Do you know Damage? Oh, you do. Amazing. All right, so Damage, formed in the 90s, basically contains one of the singers called Jay Jones, who, over the last couple of days, you're laughing, aren't you, at the mix?
Because I want the camera. I don't know why the camera is on me. Like, you know, Anna's talking. So, Miss Camera or Mr. Camera, whatever you are, I'm talking to you. I don't know, Luxie. Yeah. I'm just going to shut up right now and please point a camera at the one, the only Ana Schofield.
So let's talk about Jay Jones. He married Emma Bunton. Over the last week, they got married in secret. What was quite funny is that there's been an outpouring of messages because they just did a little Instagram saying Mr. and Mrs. Jones. Lovely. So they posted this photo and there she is in a white dress looking like Baby Spice. Baby Spice is 45. When did that happen? But she's in a sort of a white dress, but it's a mini dress. And she looks super gorge, and there she is with her lovely husband, Mr. and Mrs. Jones. But she became a radio presenter for the longest time in the UK. She worked for Capital Radio, and she was on a show with a radio presenter called Jamie Theakston, who was a very big TV presenter, and then they put him on radio. So this happened about 15 years ago, 10 years ago. They started doing that. They started putting TV presenters on radio, and so radio stations were buying in these names so that you would listen to their... because it's very competitive in the UK, radio. And also, everybody switched to podcasts. So radio is much more dominant here in the UAE market. It's very nice to be part of radio still because it's old-fashioned. People still use their cars as opposed to public transport. In the UK, there's a lot of public transport use. And when you use public transport, you don't necessarily listen to the radio. You will listen to a podcast, read a book, do something else.
UK generally is now YouTube.
YouTube, yeah.
Like they're very, like, you know, all the Kiss FMs, everybody, all the BBC... have a very, very YouTube market because, like, you know, no one is listening a lot live.
No.
You go crazy, you put it online, this is where, boom.
But as a culture, we now are listening to podcasts. That's where the market's going. The only people who really listen to a live frequency are the people who are driving in their cars. And they were banned from London. I mean, you just can't get in unless you've got millions of pounds. It's so expensive. Or you're a taxi. So it really did change the market with traffic trying to be... calm down. Very interesting. Here, not so much. We all use our big gas guzzlers and it's beautiful to be able to drive around. And until you've lived in London, a place like London where you cannot move, I think Paris is the worst for traffic. They hold the record. I saw it last night. They hold the record for the longest traffic jam in history, which is 103 kilometres long. Wow. But anyway, getting back to this. As a result, in order to attract people to the live frequencies and to get people to listen, they put TV presenters on radio. The only reason this is relevant is because they also got Emma Bunton, who had never done radio before. She rocked up and she was the co-host for Jamie Theakston, the TV presenter. Jamie actually is quite a good radio presenter now. And they were on a very famous radio station and they're co-hosts. And on the post that Emma and Jay Jones did, where they said Mr. and Mrs. Jones, there's Jamie Theakston underneath going, what? No way! Because he's really good buddies with Emma. But Emma and Jay just went off and did it in quiet. That's all they wanted to do, just get married gently. Very, very sweet. She's always been a bit like that, Emma Bunton. So let's talk about him. I thought, right, okay, let's feature him on the music. Great. So they were an R&B boy band, as you can hear. Huge success in the 90s. They had 11 hit singles, including 4 top 10. So they were doing their thing, you know. They've sold 2.6 million records worldwide. And that's records, people. When I say records, I don't mean... you press a button and you stream it. I mean vinyl. And the band consists of Jay Jones, Rahsaan Bromfield, Andres Harriet and Corey Richards, and also Noel Simpson was in there too. They formed basically because two of the members, Ras and Noel, were students at the Barbara Speake Stage School in London, and that's in Acton, and they rapped and they danced and they did all these things together, and so gradually they put this band together of all the boys, and that's how it happened. There was one student from Sylvia Young as well, I see, all the same. And They all used to sing together. They did a demo, apparently, an early demo, and they did a cover version of the Jackson 5 songs Anything. But they sampled it and they did it with other things and they sent it to Big Life Records. This was about 1995. Anyway, did super well, and throughout the late 90s, they were huge. Now, they had Love Guaranteed. They did a cover of Eric Clapton's Wonderful Tonight. They did all sorts of things. And actually, that cover, I would have played it. It reached number 3. It did really well. But it's a cover. It's not their song. Whereas this song reached number 6 in the charts. Hilarious. And they, the music underneath me, very funny. When we go really far back like this, we can't always get music without the vocals. And so we get this kind of karaoke stuff. Really funny. They did Since You've Been Gone. They did one record where they got Emma in on it. I'm just trying to think what it was. And she recorded with them because she was obviously with Jade at the time. I'm trying to think. I can't find... Oh, there it is. Emma Bunton. The song's called I Don't Know, and it featured her. But, of course, got to the early 2000s, they split up. They had their run, they split up. Then along comes, in 2014, they got together again for the second series of a documentary on ITV2. Everybody watches ITV2. And it's called The Big Reunion. And that had Eternal in, it had A1 in. I've actually covered a few other bands that had it. And it's about bringing these old bands back together and them singing. And they did it. And they've had great success with that. But also Jade Jones, turns out, is randomly a chef. Apparently he's really good. He's really good cook. And that's a good enough reason to marry him. So she did it. And looking at Jay Jones, he was born in 1979, best known for being the lead singer of this, but also went in on a Channel 4 reality show, which made him famous. And of course, I've been out of it since then. So I don't really know what's going on. But in terms of being a chef, he began training as a full-time chef and then just... has done stints at all the cool places like the Lord Stanley in Camden Town, the sister pub, the Lansdowne in Primrose Hill. If you go to Primrose Hill, Hass, and if you don't, you should. It's the one in Notting Hill, and it's the one in Love Actually. Like, everyone films in Primrose Hill. It's beautiful. And he's in the Lansdowne pub there, and it's great. And you must go and see it. And also Claridge's. See, these are big places. So he's quite a mixed bag, old Jane Jones. Can clearly sing. Absolutely lovely. And Emma Bunton married her true love of 20 years today, and we're celebrating it. So let's hear it.
If you liked this episode of Yalla Home, drop a like and subscribe. 95. Be sure to follow us on Instagram for all our daily updates and top stories.